Hello, in this video, I'm going to show you how to install under the cabinet LED lights. These are the strip lights. Now these lights can be bought at places like Home Depot or Lowe's. They peel back and stick to mostly any surface. Installing them is very easy, but in my situation, I actually want both sets of cabinets to be controlled off of one switch so everything goes on or off at the same time. I don't want to have a switch for these lights and another switch for those lights. One switch for everything. So as I noted, these are very easy to install and easy to stick to almost any surface. As I want it under the counter, I'm going to start there. And now I'm just going to measure out and see just how much I need for this section and then the following section. So right about there, and then we're going to add an additional, and sometimes it gets a bit tangly, so you want to make sure that you untangle it, and it looks like we have to stop it right about here. So anywhere you see the dotted lines, like so, that's an okay place to cut it. So this is an easier place to see it. Now, as I had noted, where you would cut it is right here in between these two dots, four dots rather. Now, one side is positive and the other side is negative, and it takes place every 4 inches, so you can see how it repeats itself. Now, you want to make sure you get right on the line, and then just cut like so. So, after we have cut along the line where the dots are, we are going to peel back the plastic about 1/2 inch so that the dots are exposed. Now use the tape to hold the strip in place. So I'm going to put one here and one here and add another piece to hold back the plastic. So using 20 gauge copper wire, which you can pretty much purchase at any store, you're going to cut about 1/2 inch off and strip it. So it's about 20. So that's why I'm putting it in the top loop there. A little longer than that because it's 1/2 inch. Once you secure it, you pull and you're good to go. And there you are. And you're gonna do that for both of them. All right, so now we're going to show you soldering. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our trusty soldering gun and I'm gonna show you how to solder. So you're first gonna take your alligator clips. You're gonna hold it upside down so the alligator is facing upside down. You are going to grab your wire here and you're gonna wanna make sure that the bare wire is attached to that dot there. That's going to ensure for a smooth connection. Now you're going to take your gun, and careful, this gun is blazing. And you're going to hold it there for about 10 seconds, holding on to the trigger, and that's going to ensure that it instantly heats up. You don't have to worry about any kind of waiting time for that bad boy. So once you've held it for about 10 seconds, you're then going to want to rub this, and that's going to ensure that it does stay together. So for soldering, we went so nice, we're going to do it twice. So here it is, we're going to do it once again. So again, you're going to heat up your soldering gun. You're going to ensure that you hold it there to make sure that you are getting a nice hot finish. And then you're going to hold it in place. And now you've got a nice secure connection, as you can see. So you're going to want to hold that so that it doesn't affect any of your areas. Again, very hot, so use with caution. And you're also going to want to ensure that you wrap the positive with some tape, just to ensure that you know the difference between positive and negative when it comes to wiring up your cabinets. So the positive is closer to me, so that's what I'm going to use. So when you're done, you unplug your gun, okay? Safety first. All right, so now that we have that, we are going to test our connection, see how it works. So we're always going to put the positive with the positive, the negative with the negative. Here we go. Okay. All right. So now we are going to plug it in to see if our connection is working. And look at that! Beautiful! I'm so proud of the finished product. Look! So I started it off here and I've moved my way down and I went all the way around and I actually came up through in here so you can see how I got the wires right inside. And then, like I said, I didn't want to have two separate switches for two separate units, so I've attached it. It's coming right through and it's again going through this cabinet so that I can have everything on one master switch. All right, so in this particular instance, I put the switch behind the fridge so that way I can actually can control the lights on off from one master switch. Alternatively, you can also use Google Home or Amazon Alexa. Now, we have a lot of great home automation tips like that. So if you want to check them out, be sure to subscribe to our videos and definitely click on like. Make your comments known. We love to hear from you. And thanks again for watching. Now we're going to look at home automation and how they compare. Alexa, turn off chandelier.
Okay.
Now we're going to try with Google. Hey Google, turn on chandelier.
Sure, turning the chandelier on.
Let's try this again. Alexa, turn off cabinet lights.
Okay.
Hey Google, turn on cabinet lights.
You got it, turning the cabinet lights on.